Welcome to this lecture video. In this video, I am going to explain attenuation and applications of optical fibers, which comes under module number 3 of engineering physics prescribed by VTU. Now let us go to the contents of this video. So here attenuation, factors causing attenuation and applications of optical fibers, that is point to point communication system in optical fibers. So what is attenuation? So attenuation is nothing but loss of power suffered by the optical signal during its propagation through an optical fiber, and it is expressed as decibel per kilometer. So attenuation is nothing but the loss of power suffered by the optical fiber during its propagation through an optical fiber. A fiber with a lower attenuation will allow more power to reach its receiver than a fiber with higher attenuation. If PEIN is the input power and POU2 out is the output power, after passing through the optical fiber of length L, the attenuation constant or attenuation coefficient alpha is given by alpha is equal to minus 10 by L logarithm base 10 P out by P n, so many dB per kilometer. So the attenuation coefficient alpha is given by minus 10 by L logarithm of 10 P out by P n, so many dB per kilometer. Here L is length of the optical fiber and PIN is nothing but input power coupled into the optical fiber, and the P out is nothing but output power of the optical fiber after traveling a distance of length L. So factors causing attenuation, there are three factors: absorption loss, scattering loss and radiation loss. So these were all the three factors causes attenuation, that is loss of power suffered by the optical signal. So one is macroscopic bending. So here is a picture. The optical fiber bends, and whenever the optical signal reaches the bending part, so the total internal reflection condition will not satisfy. That's why it will enter the cladding as shown in the picture. So the optical signal coupled into optical fiber is coming out of the cladding once it reaches a bending portion as shown in the picture, where the angle of incidence may not satisfy the total internal reflection. That's why it will come out of the cladding. Microscopic bending, so here is a picture, and whenever an optical signal reaches this microscopic bending part, it is a manufacturer defect, and whenever it reaches that microscopic bending part, it will come out of the cladding as shown in the picture. So leads to power loss or leads to attenuation, known as microscopic bending. And when we look at the scattering and absorption loss, so absorption loss is coming to picture whenever a radiation passes through an optical fiber, it will come in contact with atoms of the core. The atom itself absorbs the radiation and get excited to excited state, leads to fiber loss. That is, optical signal loss is coming to picture because of the atoms of the cladding absorbs some portion of light and is considered as absorption loss. And also absorption loss coming to picture whenever the coupled optical signal met with the impurity atoms present in the core. So impurity atoms absorbs light and leads to attenuation. And scattering loss is nothing but whenever a optical signal reaches impurity atoms or some other atoms, it will get scattered in a particular direction. That's why it will come out of the cladding. So this is also considered as a cause for attenuation, known as scattering loss. So these were all the three types of losses that we observe. So in case of radiation loss, we come across the microscopic bending, and another one is microscopic bending and macroscopic bending. So these two were all the cases of radiation loss. And when we come to the application part of optical fiber, so here is a schematic diagram of a point-to-point communication system. So here optical fiber is used to transmit optical, that is voice signal, over a large distance. So voice signal is converted into electrical analog form and it is sent to coder and then it will send to optical transmitter. That optical transmitter is sends or transmit a voice signal in the form of optical signal and coupled that into optical fiber as shown in the picture. The optical signal is finally reaches a photo detector that will be converted into a decoder and then convert back into electrical analog signal and then finally it will be converted into voice at the receiving end. So the optical fiber is used here for transmitting voice over a long distance. So it will be used in a communication system or in telephone industry. So this is what the application of optical fiber considered as point to point communication, and this is what the block diagram of optical fiber. A optical fiber with an input power of 9 microwatt has a loss of 1.5 dB per kilometer. If the fiber is 3000 meter long, calculate the output power. So PI is 9 microwatts, that is 9 × 10⁻⁶ watts, and alpha is 1.5 dB per kilometer and L is 3000 meter or 3 kilometer. So what is P output? That is power output. So we know that lambda, that is alpha, is equal to minus 10 by L log of P naught by PI. Then therefore P naught can be written as PI into 10⁻⁻⁶ alpha L by 10. So substituting the value of alpha and L here and also the value of PI, then P naught will be 3019 × 10⁻⁶ watts. So this is what the solution for this problem. So once again, PI is 9 microwatts and alpha is 1.5 dB per kilometer and L is 3 kilometers. So we have to calculate what is P output. So using the formula, alpha is equal to minus 10 by L log of P naught by PI. So P naught is written as PI into 10⁻⁻⁶ alpha L by 10. So by substituting the value of alpha and L here, the value of P naught will be 3019 × 10⁻⁶ watts. A signal with input power 200 milliwatt loses 10% of its power after traveling a distance of 3000 meter. Find the attenuation coefficient of the fiber. So here PI is 200 milliwatts, P naught is 90% of PI, that is 0.9 × 200 × 10⁻³ watts, and then L is 3000 meter or 3 kilometer. So we know that alpha is equal to minus 10 by L logarithm of P naught by PI. Therefore alpha is written as minus 10 by 3 into log of, that is P naught by PI. So P naught is 0.9 × 200 × 10⁻³, and PI is 200 × 10⁻³. And on simplification, the value of alpha is equal to 0.1525 dB per kilometer. So this is what the solution for the given problem. Once again, so the input power is 200 milliwatts and the output power is 10% of its value, and it is traveled over a distance of 3 kilometer or 3000 meter, and we have to calculate what is the attenuation coefficient alpha. So as per the formula, alpha is equal to minus 10 by L logarithm of P naught by PI. So substitute the value of L, P naught and PI and then simplify, then we will get alpha is equal to 0.1525 dB per kilometer. An optical fiber has core refract index 1.5 and refract index of cladding is 3% less than that of core. Calculate the numerical aperture, angle of acceptance and internal critical acceptance angle. So here N1 is 1.5, N2 is 97% of N1, that is equal to 1.455, and N0 is 1. What is numerical aperture? What is theta naught and theta c? So we know that numerical aperture is equal to square root of N1 square minus N2 square by N0. That is equal to square root of 1.5 square minus 1.455 square whole divided by 1. That is equal to 0.365. And sin theta naught is nothing but numerical aperture. Therefore, theta naught is equal to sin inverse numerical aperture. That is equal to sin inverse of 0.365. That is equal to 21.41 degrees. That is what the value of theta naught. And sin theta c is equal to n2 by n1. Therefore, theta c is equal to sin inverse of n2 by n1. Substitute the value of n2 and n1 here. Then on simplification, the value of theta c is equal to 75.93 degrees. So this is what the solution for the given problem. Thank you.